Hi guys, and welcome back to another video. Today we're going to go through the feedback letter that I got from Cambridge. Some of you have asked to make a video on it, so here it is. I only got feedback on the first rejection, on the second one, only because I was a little bit too hurt after the second one to actually ask for it. So only Fitzwilliam gave me their feedback and not Downing. I do regret not asking Downing for my feedback, but I mean, I think it's a little bit too late now. So let's go on with... First of all, they didn't send it to me, but they sent it to my school. They did beat around the bush a little bit, but anyways, here we go. I write with feedback concerning the application by Kevin Fang to read psychological and behavioural sciences at Fitzwilliam. The candidate has given permission for this information to be sent to you, and you are of course welcome to discuss it with them. We prefer to send feedback on unsuccessful applicants to schools and colleges rather than to applicants themselves, as we believe that it is helpful if referees put the information in context. Teachers will have a clearer picture of applicants' schoolwork and other university applications. I hope that you will find our response constructive and that it will convey some sense of what we are looking for. They send it to my school because I think they believe they can sort of contextualise a little bit better and sort of get, convey the point a little bit easier to the students. Let's go on to the next section. We carefully review all individual applications at length, and each year we found ourselves turning down able candidates who have the potential to do well at Cambridge. The university receives an average of 5 applications per place, so the majority of applicants in any given year will be unsuccessful. Each application is considered individual and holistically. We take into consideration all information provided to us, including academic record, school reference, personal statement, performance in any test and interview, as well as any contextual data. Competition is intense and we have limited places. This year we received close to 600 applications for around 140 places. So there's a lot of competition for these places, around I think 1 in 5. And I think for my specific course, it was like a 23% chance of getting in. So that's sort of the, I guess, the whole side of it, and sort of statistical side of it. A lot of this letter is sort of contextualizing a lot of stuff, and there's only a small chunk of it that actually is sort of relevant, but we'll keep on going with it. Kevin submitted a strong application to read psychological and behavioral sciences at Fitzwilliam. We noted his above average performance in an admission assessment, his academic record and supportive school reference, and we were pleased to be able to invite him to interview. So basically, I actually applied with 2 A stars predicted and an A. And my GCSEs were okay. I think I had 7 A's, 2 B's and 2 C's. So I was actually really, really worried about my GCSE grades letting me down, because everyone else who's applying all have A stars and everything. So I was actually really surprised about when they said that I had an above average performance in admission assessment, which I did really work really hard for. And also my academic record, which I sort of thought was going to be the downside of everything. But apparently it was good. So let's keep going. At interview, applicants are asked a range of questions, which may include general questions on the personal motivation and interest in the subject, topics raised in the personal statement, and some technical problems designed to assess the suitability for the course. The main focus of interviews at Cambridge is to explore whether candidates are able to show confidence and ability when faced with familiar concepts, intellectual flexibility and analytical reasoning when confronted with new and more challenging material, and a capacity to work through problems in a systematic manner. This is how interviews at Cambridge sort of work. They sort of give you new pieces of information, and you have to use the information that you kind of know beforehand, adapt them and sort of translate them into the questions that they're asking you. So yeah, let's go on to the next section. In the case of Kevin, the interviewers were of the opinion that although he was able to address general questions, and this shows some very good insights at times when considering methods and data analysis, he had difficulty in developing topics further and required prompting throughout the interviews. Yeah, so I kind of did do that. I didn't develop the topics that I touched on very far. I sort of just touched the surface of it, and I didn't really want to go into depth. I kind of thought if I did go into depth, I'd be seems like a bit of a show off. So I didn't actually talk about it that much. I just sort of briefly touched on topics and talked about a lot of different topics for a specific question, but not in depth into them. I didn't sort of have that critical thinking that they, I guess, are looking for. So I maybe for one question they asked, I think I answered like maybe 5 or 6 different topic areas, but I sort of just touched the surface, didn't actually go into any depth, try and utilize that theory. How does that theory apply to the question that they asked? I sort of just said the theory, brief explanation, and then left it at there. So I guess the feedback is quite true, and it sort of is representative of how I sort of perceived the interview to have gone. So let's get on to the next part. This mixed performance meant that the overall assessment of his application was that he was not in the very top part of the gathered field. We felt it was clearly worthwhile making his application available to other colleges through the pool, but unfortunately no other college wished to take his application further. Yeah. The feedback they gave was actually quite vague. They didn't go into that much depth about why I actually didn't get in. Kind of like my interview actually. But the main points I sort of gathered from this was that I had good grades beforehand, but I didn't go into depth in my interviews. I sort of just touched the surface and didn't use any of the critical thinking skills that I know that I have, but I was sort of too scared to use because I didn't want to be seen like a show off. So that's sort of what kind of led, I guess, to the eventual downfall of my applications. Yeah, that's all they said in the feedback letter. If you guys liked the video, please like and subscribe, and cheers.